Hi everyone, Eddie Harold for Breathe Aware. Today I want to talk about breathing at the workplace. And I'm involved in corporate America at a pretty deep level in regard to reducing stress, amplifying performance, taking care of the heart rate, great posture, and being in a state of flow in the brain so that we're emotionally and mentally as resilient as possible, going through the peaks and valleys of trying for our very best at any given moment during the day. So let's talk about breathing at work. Number one, it's fundamentally diaphragmatic breathing through the nostrils all the time, stalling aging in the brain, receiving information coming in, processing it in your interpersonal dialogue, and then creating a reaction or an action if it's required. Number two, always exhaling longer than your inhale. Remember, work is an endurance event. You're going to be in higher states of mental concentration for 8, 9, 10, 12 hours, whatever it may be. So I would train you the same way I would train an endurance athlete. It's fat metabolism all the way. How do we burn fat metabolism? Well, we know fat metabolism takes place on the exhale. It's amplified on the exhale through the nostrils because the exhale is longer in length and the pace of the exhale is slower. Number two, when you're inhaling slowly and you're creating good physical posture at the workplace, you're saving energy. So it takes less energy to hold you erect. And when the brain sees the spine erect in your chair, it's easy for the brain to spin all the different plates and all the balloons you have up in the air at any given moment, and you're controlling the plates. You're controlling the balloons. You're controlling the emails. They're not controlling you. When you're making a transition from one meeting to another, or your desk to another place, going to another floor, it's nasal diaphragmatic breathing with a four-part breath. So you get a mild cardiovascular response. What that might look like is you inhale, hold the breath in 3 or 4 seconds, exhale, hold the breath out 3 or 4 seconds. So actually while you're walking to the next work task, you're actually getting a wonderful cardiovascular response as if you were running, but you're only walking. And it gives you the ability to kind of shut down what just happened. Make that transition, get present again, and put your feet back on the ground so you can deliver professional services for the next meeting you're going into. So whenever you're moving from one place to another, it's the four-part breath. Inhale as slowly as possible, eyes and jaw completely relaxed. Relax your arms, plug into your legs. Brief breath retention, anywhere from 3 to 5 seconds. Exhale through your nose. Really detox and signal to the nerve endings of the lungs that you want to relax and release serotonin and amplify your vagus nerve. And then hold the breath out for a couple seconds. And this helps detox the body of stale air from previous stresses that's impeding the next inhale to come in and fully give you the mental and emotional and physical vitality that you need to be your best at any given moment to meet your standards first and everyone else's standards second. Whenever you have the opportunity, take the stairs and create some rhythm going up and down the stairs. Let the hands cross the center line of your body. And in the center line of your body, this helps synchronize the two prefrontal cortexes. So again, you're not using half your brain to get through the day, you're using your whole brain. And when you're using your whole brain, you're a lot more resilient. You stay more centered and grounded, and you create what we call flow. And we know that athletes or folks in corporate America that are in flow adapt to the environment very quickly. They learn things on the fly. They're very creative. Their creativity rises anywhere between 500 to 700%. So being at flow in the workplace is an amazing tool for you not only to make yourself happy, but fulfill your needs of what you've chosen to do in your life, but to help everyone else around you achieve their goals. So work on this four-part breath when you're making a transition. Whenever you feel like maybe it's gotten a little too emotional or you've lost the heart, your feet are unplugged, alternate nostril breathing. Just let your eyes close, you bring up the thumb, you close off the right nostril, you inhale up the left as slowly as you can, stabilize the mental content, close off the left, release the thumb, exhale right. Eyes and jaw are completely relaxed. Inhale up the right. Close off the right, release out the left. 3 to 4 rounds of this I'd say it's maybe a minute. It's amazing to what it can do for your brain. In other words, it'll cool the left prefrontal cortex down where it's become overheated. Too many thoughts, we feel like we're losing control, we're falling behind in the information. It'll activate the right prefrontal cortex, which is very cooling. It's serotonin based. It gives you the ability to let go of thoughts that aren't your best, and the right brain will begin to speak to the left brain, and you'll be more centered and grounded for your next professional or personal task. My name's Eddie Harold. Try these techniques. I know they work, and they're going to change your life, and you're going to smile a lot more with BreatheAware. Thanks for watching.